SPUR, and it's great to see you for the Good Government Awards. What is it that we're here to do? Yeah, thank you, everybody. I appreciate that. Why are we here? We are here to celebrate the people that make this city work. Sometimes it happens in life that our attention is most drawn to what's not working. It's drawn to the problems. That is just human nature. We take for granted so often the things that work because they're not causing problems. So what we're doing today, we are taking a moment to reflect on what does work. We're taking a moment to celebrate the people who have devoted themselves to doing the people's business. That's what this is about. This event is very meaningful to me because I think it expresses San Francisco values in a very authentic, very meaningful way. It does that because we believe in government as a tool for good. Yeah, so thank you. We believe in a government as a tool for good, so we need all of the people who devote themselves to public service. So today is also a very meaningful day to me because this is the first Good Government Awards where we have a new director of SPUR San Francisco. And this is her eighth day on the job, and I am referring to Christine Johnson, known to many of you for her service on the Planning Commission, known to some of you for her work as a consultant to cities, helping with city contracting, known to others of you for her service on many nonprofit boards and public commissions. So it is with great pleasure that I want to bring up on stage for the first time in this role, Christine Johnson, Director of SPUR San Francisco. Thank you.
Hi, good evening, everyone. Thank you all for being here. It's a packed room. I really appreciate seeing all of your faces, many of whom I've met in various roles that I've had. So I started just 8 days ago, I guess it's SPUR, and my background's in public finance and also public service. I've lived in San Francisco for 13, 14 years now. It's hard to believe that the time flies. I've been on the Hunters Point CAC. I was one of the founding members of the OCII Commission and the Planning Commission. Thank you, Mayor Lee. And I've served on many other various nonprofit boards. I'd been serving on the board of SPUR for a year when Gabe asked me to join, and I immediately said yes, and then I thought about it later, and that's another decision. I don't know if my gut was telling me to say yes, and I thought about it later. And I realized I wanted to work for SPUR, and my immediate yes is because it's the same reason that I was excited to join the board. SPUR is aligned with my vision of a San Francisco that is inclusive for everyone and works for everyone. Many people think of SPUR being involved in discussions around housing and real estate development, but they work in so many other areas. Environment, sustainability, open space, how we get around, transportation, and really every aspect of what it takes to have vibrant working urban areas. There's super smart staff, an engaged board, and I just felt honored to join such a great group of people, and I hope I can jump to some policy discussions and do a really great job and work with many of you. So as I look around, as I see a lot of people that I've worked with in previous roles, I look forward to the success we'll accomplish together. I'm focused on hopefully looking at, big structural problems and generational problems, things that cross boundaries of districts and departments. And so I'm hoping to tackle many of those areas with all of you. So getting to why we're here tonight, my path to SPUR was through volunteerism and public service. I have technical skills in public finance, but really I'm here because I love to serve this city. In my various time on boards and commissions, I've had the opportunity to work with many different departments,
And I found that those who work for SF personify public service in a way that I've always aspired to and has kept me going with all of the things that I have done. So tonight's awardees have made outstanding achievements, and I'm excited to help celebrate them all tonight, and I hope that you all are all as well. And congratulations to all of our awardees and the family and friends that they brought here tonight. So, in the spirit of keeping things short so everyone can get back to the wine and the bar in the back, I'd like to ask our Finance Committee Chair, Chris Cowell, to come up, and then we will move on with our program. Thank you very much.
All right. You can see all the developers kind of moving to the side of the room. Whoops, she's going that way. Everyone gets a vote tonight at the Good Government Awards if you're a developer. I'm kidding. I want to take a moment to thank the folks that helped sponsor tonight. And I know a lot of people in government, we talk about public-private partnerships. And the reality is, this city is run every day by a public-private partnership. The city could not function without a lot of the companies that are in this room. And I want to mention a few of the folks who stepped up, and they're the same folks that do it every year, and you're so generous, and this city can't run without you. SPUR does not exist without your support, and of course these awards wouldn't be possible without your generosity. First and foremost, I'm not going to mention the departments out by name, but some of the largest contributors tonight are the actual departments who are your partners every day here in San Francisco as well. But starting up from the top, Autodesk, Boston Properties, Bridge Housing, Treasure Island Development Corporation, Google, HOK, Microsoft, the Municipal Executive Association, Perkins and Will, Recology, Skidmore, Owens and Merrill, Trumark Urban, Webcor, Accenture, AECOM, the Shorenstein Company, Cerner, Black & Veatch, Chariot, Prado Group, Clear Channel Outdoors, who has put all the winners' faces on bus stops all around town. If you haven't seen them yet, you all look fabulous, and so many more. So thank you for everything you do to help sponsor these awards, and again, thank you for helping make this city work. And now it's time for the man who makes this city really work, and that is our own Mayor Lee.
Thank you, Chris and Gabe and Christine, for working with all the sponsors to put this on. As I look out the room, I am deeply appreciative of everybody here tonight to honor and recognize very well-deserving individuals and teams of individuals. So I'm up here for the sixth time in my 26 years, jealous, envious, a little bitter, because I never won one of these awards. And here I am, as your mayor. Still, Gabe, I'm waiting. One of these days, maybe I'll earn the stripes, but as I look out and I see the faces of those that are honored this year, and as I especially look out to the department heads who are proudly encasing their work, I too am very proud because I recognize how difficult it is to really rise and live up to the challenges that each one of these projects that will be highlighted tonight, the things that people worked on and excelled in, do represent the values of our city, the need for the collaboration, the certainly what Chris said earlier, the not only the public-private partnerships, but the incredible public service it takes. And at the heart of it is the reminder that I'm sure in the middle of all this and their efforts, they have to keep reminding themselves, I'm a public servant. I've got to do better than just exist. And I know that President Breed and former supervisor and now Assemblyman David Chu are here tonight to also I think, represent their personal satisfaction with these awards, because they know that throughout their careers, and especially in San Francisco, it takes some brilliant stars to make you look good, whether we're elected officials or department heads. And I just want to recognize tonight, you know, just the work that people did, because as you read through and listen tonight, you'll hear how important this are to transform a whole kind of poisoned island, if you will, into a facility where 8,000 homes will be, that Bob Beck's taken up that responsibility at Treasure Island. When you know that these outlandish, crazy TNCs going to our airport in the most unorganized way, trying to get a piece of the action, and turn that into a smooth regulatory process that even IVAR knows, generating $25 million of extra income, of which we get a percent. I was telling IVAR, I seldom do I ever get the percent of all the landing fees, but now we got something going here that Eva really has created with her leadership. You know, I've been preaching to our entire environmental community, and I know Debbie knows this, that Donnie's work is dear to my heart, because I've always wanted an environmental movement that included us, you know, women and people and minority communities, to make sure that we were never left out of that environmental movement, because the environments that many minority communities survived in were the ones that we were always talking about trying to improve. So Donnie, thank you for your leadership in making sure we have a culturally competent environmental department that makes all of our information relevant and reachable. You know, you can't say more, you know, this is the center of debate now on our healthcare across the country. But know this, we are on the map to be one of those cities in the country that performed the best, because we had a San Francisco Benefits Net team that really broke through so many barriers to make sure people were enrolled in Medi-Cal and CalFresh. And I know Trent is very proud of the entire team that worked really hard and broke through many barriers. And that's why we continue to say we're going to need that health care, because we got so many people enrolled by this team. And also, finally, the Zuckerberg SF General, obviously an institution that touches all of our hearts, to know that we never hear about bumps in the road when we're moving all of those people from the old hospital to the new one. And I can't think it's just because they were so happy to move into a seismically safe facility, or that the team itself was brilliant in its backdrop of making sure that move was so smoothly handled. Each and every one of these projects are important to the city, important to the departments, important to representing our values. And at the backdrop, and I want to thank again SPUR, the Good Government Awards, all the private sector sponsorships of the tonight, is that we are making government work here. It is not true of other governments, but it is true here in San Francisco. So, Gabe and Chris and Christine, I got 3 more years, and I'm still looking forward to an award that I can proudly say, but tonight, let's honor those who have stepped up, stepped out, been the collaborators, been the team leaders, show that government can really be the greatest part of the city, because we're keeping in touch with the people who need the services and doing that in the highest innovative way. Congratulations to each and every one of you. thank you, everybody, for recognizing their efforts.
Thank you, everyone, and thank you, Mayor Lee. We'd like to get us started with our today's program. We'll start off with our first awardee. I'm pleased to announce our first Good Government Award winners of the evening, the Zuckerberg San Francisco General Hospital MOVE team.
So the MOVE could be shaped as one day. One day, we moved all patients from one facility into a new facility. It was an exciting day, but it's more than the one day. It's everything that led up to that one day. It encompasses 3 years of planning, over 250 meetings with the staff to coordinate and grow our program.
The MOVE was a multi-year process to ensure that the building was safe for patient care and met all the regulatory standards. It took a village to open the building.
Collaboration was essential for the success of training staff across multiple disciplines. I think it was a huge culture shift. The anxiety and preparation, anticipation of moving into this space, I think was one of the things that we had to work through as an organization.
We worked with stakeholders from every department and every service line daily to make sure that the space was ready, the staff were ready, and we were ultimately prepared for safe patient care. What we learned was the workflows in this building were so completely different that most needed to be changed and optimized to provide safe patient care here.
We're very excited to achieve LEED Gold, which is the first level one trauma center in the nation that has achieved LEED Gold, and we're very proud of that.
Opening a new trauma center is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and I just want to congratulate our staff who did an incredible job of really trying to make sure that we had a smooth transition into a new hospital. And they did that with incredible foresight and also incredible planning.
One of the most important things about the building is that our patients are in a healing, modern environment. A lot of the patient comments on the first day of MOVE were how beautiful it is and how quiet it is. It just enhances their wellness.
How incredible was that? I'm so honored on behalf of the CEO of the hospital, Dr. Ehrlich, and Roland Pickens, our network director. I want to call up and make sure that we honor the Zuckerberg San Francisco General Hospital MOVE team, Justin, Jay Clue, Terry Saltz, and Jeffrey Smith. Come on up.
Thank you. So I'd really like to thank Mayor Ed Lee, Director Barbara Garcia for all their support throughout this project. As I said, it takes a village, and we are really proud to accept this award on behalf of the leadership team and all the staff at Zuckerberg San Francisco General. As I said, it takes a village, and there were many meetings and many late nights that we spent together and became a close family. I would ask that anyone that is from San Francisco General, could you just stand up? Because you are all a part of this, and we just really want to thank you. I also really just want to thank the citizens of San Francisco. As you know, it was a bond measure, $880 million, and they came out and they voted in strong numbers in support of public health in our new building. And that's really, really meaningful for us. So thank you very much.
Congratulations again. Please join me in honoring our next Good Government Award winner, Donnie Oliveira from the Department of the Environment.
In 2009, then Mayor Newsom challenged city agencies across the city to help support those unemployed with jobs through a federal grant. The Jobs Now program was formed, and our department took the challenge on. So we hired 40 San Francisco residents to come in, and we trained them up to be our environmental ambassadors. They became the faces in the community, communicating our programs and initiatives. And then for the first year, we were able to show significant impact to our programs and our initiatives, so much so that the department internalized the program and found funding to keep it going. For the longest time, the department's Zero Waste program has been its flagship environmental initiative. Our Zero Waste program is focused on getting as much material, actually all material, out of the landfill or incineration by 2020. And for many years, it's been wildly successful. It's one of the most successful major city programs in the country. We're at the point now where the lowest hanging fruit has been captured. We realized, how are we going to take this very complex strategy with complicated goals and frame it in a way that's accessible to as many people as possible? We started to ask ourselves and ask the community, what messages resonate with you and how do we deliver tailored messaging and outreach so that you can best understand our programs, but also we can help you achieve the most success.
San Francisco is going to have to hire the best and the brightest if we are going to be able to meet our ambitious environmental goals. And Donnie is that. Donnie is very comfortable in the realm of digital media, in social marketing, in survey technology. He uses all of that to craft a very unique, targeted message that is so effective and compelling that San Francisco actually leads the world when it comes to environmental programming and outreach.
That challenge of how do we reach as many people as possible exists every day. No one solution is going to reach everybody, so we're constantly testing and modifying and learning about the best way to shape hearts and minds of San Francisco.
What an amazing opportunity to celebrate government and to celebrate civil service. It feels like I'm just getting bombarded, as all of you are, about the evils of government. And yet, tonight is a night where we celebrate the heroes of government. And I would say that every single one of these employees could have a job anywhere they wanted, but they chose a life of public service. And we owe them a huge thank you for that decision. And I am so deeply honored to recognize my colleague, Donnie Oliveira, for his incredible achievements.
Good evening. Thanks, everyone. And colleagues, congratulations. Mr. Mayor, thank you. So first and foremost, I want to say it's a real honor to be up here, not just because I'm very passionate about the work that we do at the Department of the Environment, but also, I'm genuinely honored and privileged to work with a fabulous group of people at the Department of the Environment, both from our leadership with Debbie Rafael all the way down to the staff that work day to day, grinding out, providing good messaging, thoughtful wording to the ways that we want to make our city more resilient, more sustainable, not just for this generation, but for generations, for years to come. I can't stress this enough, ladies and gentlemen, the urgency of which we're facing climate change is unprecedented. Not just because of what's happening really right now with our sea level rise issues, but that there's real challenges nationally on how we're addressing these issues. And if we're going to really move the needle forward, San Francisco is going to continue to be a beacon of leadership and hope for how we move the messaging forward, not just in San Francisco, across borders. Because climate change knows no borders, no boundaries. I'm accepting this award because I'm very passionate about the environment, but I want to take you back 20 years to a poem that I heard that really inspired me to get to the where I'm at today, and I'm going to leave you with that. It's 3:23 in the morning, and I'm awake because my great-great-grandchildren won't let me sleep. My great-great-grandchildren asked me in my dreams, what did you do while the planet was plundered? What did you do when the earth was unraveling? Surely you did something when the season started failing, as the mammals, reptiles, birds were all dying. Did you fill the streets with protests when democracy was stolen? What did you do once you knew? Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, and congratulations, Donnie. Before we get to our next awardee, I'd like to acknowledge that we are also joined tonight by California State Assemblyman David Chu. Thank you for coming. And President of our Board of Supervisors, London Breed, was here earlier as well. I'd like to thank her for attending tonight. So moving to our next awardee, please join me in honoring our next Good Government Award winner, Eva Chong from the San Francisco International Airport.
Our team in the airport makes sure that everybody who goes through here has a seamless experience, whether it's through the checkpoint, we're managing the queues, we're monitoring that, or it's the check-in process, the gates, that your planes can get in and out easily and on time. Wayfinding is a big part of this too, and make sure people can find their way. A happy customer is one that can get on their plane and not feel stressed when they go through the airport. TNC stands for Transportation Network Company. So most people know them as Uber, probably the most popular, Lyft is the second. About the end of 2012, so 2013, we finally accepted that they were here to stay, that they had a huge customer base, that people wanted to take TNCs, it was convenient for them, they liked the services. So we moved into permit development. Commercial operators all pay fees to the airport, so it's not fair to have another operator out there that's paying fees. So we developed a tracking tool with a geofence around the airport that helps us track them for enforcement, and then they pay us a transaction fee, just like every other ground transportation operator does. When we started this, we reached out to other airports and said, well, what are you doing? To try to figure out where to go. And unfortunately, no one else had the same volume that we had or at the same time because all those companies started here. So it was in the beginning kind of feeling like we were out there on the raft by ourselves.
Eva has been so instrumental in managing through the advent of transportation network companies, and the leadership that Eva has brought to this has just been incredible for us and really has set a model nationally on how you permit their operations at airports. In 2016 alone, we had almost 22 million trips by these transportation network companies. We just are so thrilled with Eva's work and leadership with these TNC companies and the successful permitting and this model that has become a national standard.
At the end of the day, we're here to serve the customers. It's a new industry that the public was ready to embrace, so we felt it was important that we did as well.
I'm Ivar Satterow, Airport Director for SFO. And this is such a proud moment for our airport. And I think we talk a lot about our core values at SFO and driving a culture of innovation and excellence. And Eva just exemplifies that all day long, every day, and her commitment to coming up with solutions that are very challenging, disruptive, but taking those and turning those to our advantage. And this is one tremendous example, and there's a lot of others, and so I'm so proud that we're here to honor Eva Chong for this award, this Good Government Award. Eva.
I can tell everybody from the airport's not shy to disrupt. I'm very humbled and honored to be up here to take this award today, and I will say this was by no means an individual effort, so I do want to recognize the team that helped kind of change our permitting and processes. We've got Landside Operations, Angus Duvall, Legal Department, Stacy Lucas. This was a long journey for us through Sacramento and San Francisco and many different places with the TNCs. And of course, our IT team who developed record groundbreaking technology for us. So thank you very much. I'm very honored.
Thank you and congratulations.
One more SPUR change to announce, which is connected a little bit to our next award winner, Faye Sen, who has a long history of service to the city as a founding member of CCDC and also a SPUR board member, has rotated on to become the chair of the San Francisco board. So I look forward to working with her, and we look forward to working with all of you. She also serves on the as chair of the Treasure Island Development Authority Board, which is connected closely to our next Good Government Award winner from the Treasure Island Development Authority. Administrators, please join me in honoring Bob Beck.
I joined TIDA in July of 2013, and the project was entitled, but development had not yet begun. The initial development plan was drafted in 1996, but it wasn't until 2011 that a final plan and environmental evaluation was completed. The development program on Treasure Island is primarily a residential one. We'll be building 8,000 new homes, 2,173 of which will be affordable. There's about 500,000 square feet of commercial and retail space on the island, primarily intended to be neighborhood serving. So grocery stores, pharmacies, the things that you would need for a community of roughly 20,000 residents. There'll also be up to 500 hotel rooms connected to downtown San Francisco through bus and ferry service. One of the questions that frequently comes up is what are we doing for sea level rise and building a new community in the middle of the bay? Initially, we're going to be importing as much as 3 million cubic yards of soil to the island. That raises the development footprint and perimeter of the island for 100-year storm surges plus 16 to 36 inches of sea level rise. Public financing for the program comes from an infrastructure revitalization and financing district and a community facilities district. And just this last January, we completed the process of the initial formation of those districts through the Board of Supervisors. A project of this scale has so many moving parts. The sequencing and phasing challenges are significant.
There were many people who thought Treasure Island would not happen. It was a huge puzzle to solve. And Bob Beck came right in, undeterred by any of the issues, and was able to work with each and every one of those agencies and the stakeholders, all the residents who lived out on Treasure Island and Yerba Buena Island, the Board of Supervisors and the mayor, to solve this problem. It will be a great place to live in San Francisco.
Everybody's been pulling together on this for a long time. Now that it's actually coming to fruition, people are really focused on doing what it takes to make sure that things get implemented. And working on Treasure Island is such a beautiful location that you can't help but be aware of what it is that you're trying to build and the asset that you're trying to deliver to the future.
Good evening. About 5 years ago, I was called to a meeting to talk about the wastewater treatment plant out on Treasure Island that was currently owned by the Navy, but yet city employees were maintaining and just basically keeping it together. And there was a sense of panic in this meeting about this wastewater treatment plant was going to fail, and those are residents out there, San Francisco residents out there on Treasure Island, and this could be an environmental catastrophe. So the SFPUC, they were doing great in trying to put Band-Aid and duct tape and keeping this wastewater treatment going. But then General Manager of the Public Utilities Commission, who I think is here today, Ed Harrington, turns around to me and says, Naomi, how do we expedite the long-term goal and expedite development on this island so that we have a real wastewater treatment plant? And I looked at him and said, oh my goodness. I didn't say, but in my mind, I'm like, oh my gosh, this is beyond my skill set. And I said, I'll get back to you in a couple of weeks. I walked out that door and called Bob Beck and said, hey, I have a job for you. It's a puzzle. You'll be able to solve it. And didn't you start your career in the wastewater division at DPW that then moved over to the PUC? You'll love this job. And he, of course, was very intrigued by it and ultimately accepted my offer. And as you can see, development has begun on Treasure Island. With that, I'd like to give the award to Bob Beck.
Thank you. I'd like to thank my wife, Janai, for her support in the work that I do, but I also really want to thank SPUR for providing this forum where efforts of city employees can be recognized, because there are so many that are deserving and so many that go unrecognized, as Mayor Lee pointed out. I started my career with the city in 1988, and so thanking everyone who has been a valued peer, mentor, or role model would be impossible, but I do need to mention a few. My roommates in college, Fernando Cisneros and Emilio Cruz, who were interns with the city and without whose influence I literally would not be here. Larry Wong, my first supervisor in construction management, who maintained a binder of essential reading for new construction inspectors and made sure to spend time every day reviewing material with them. Ted Wisnia and Dennis Huey, the mechanical engineering section manager and assistant section manager at DPW, who I later followed to the Public Utilities Commission and about whom I could never say enough. When I returned to DPW in 1999, I had the great privilege to work with the Director of Public Works, Mark Primo, and his remarkable team, including Harlan Kelly, Tina Olson, Chris McDaniels, and Ann Godfrey. And then when Mark left the city to work with then Director of Public Works, Ed Lee. Which brings me back to today in Treasure Island. I need to thank Mayor Lee and Naomi Kelly for the opportunity to work on this fantastic project. Supervisor Kim and her staff, Ivy, Bobby, and April, for the support of the Treasure Island community and the Treasure Island program. The former directors of development, Stephen Proud, Jack Sylvan, and Michael Timoff, for the years of often thankless work that made this project possible. And all the city staff that are helping to implement this project, Barbara Moy and everyone at DPW, Nadia Sasse in the Office of Public Finance, Charles Sullivan with the City Attorney's Office, Dave Briggs with Public Utilities Commission, Rachel Hyatt and Eric Cordoba with the Transportation Authority, and so many, many more. I also need to thank the partnership that we have with our development partner, Treasure Island Community Development, led by Chris Meenian, Kofi Bonner, but also the folks on the ground, Kay Loke, James Suh, Joe Antonio, Alex Galovich, Ellen Warner, Julian Pancos, Kevin Arrow. Also, Sherry Williams with the Treasure Island Homeless Development Initiative, but first and foremost, the TIDA board, the TIDA cab, and TIDA staff, Rich Rivetti, Liz Hirshhorn, Miriam Saez, Peter Somerville, Kate Austin, Nikki Ivey, Lorraine Lee, and Jack Nathanson. Thank you.
Thank you and congratulations. Lastly, we congratulate the team of dedicated public servants from the Human Services Agency who have worked on the San Francisco Benefits Net team.
SF Benefits Net was formed to effectively implement the Affordable Care Act in San Francisco. SF Benefits Net was really formed by taking the food stamp program, or CalFresh, and the Medi-Cal program and combining them, implementing new customer queuing technology and tasking technology, all in advance of implementing the Affordable Care Act about 3 years ago.
We went from about 60 to 70 people walking in our doors per day to an average of 600 per day, and that was a big impact. We only hired about 8 extra staff, not thinking we would need as many as we would. And our staff got innovative, they were passionate, their biggest concern was the wait time for clients.
Our motto is no wrong door. Once we created SF Benefits Net, clients could go to both offices and apply for both benefits and be served at both offices. My co-manager, Noel, and I, we do a lot of work behind the scenes. Noel and I get the opportunity to work and collaborate with other programs and departments. We tend to look at ourselves as the glue that keeps everything together. There's a running joke around, they call us Middle Earth, because there's CalFresh, there's Medi-Cal, and then there are the operations in the middle.
One thing that we don't talk about a lot is an online form called My Benefits CalWin. And historically, Medi-Cal clients didn't use it very often. We'd have about 5 a month. We now have about 700 a month.
The fourth quarter of 2016, almost 40% of our applications came in online.
With the passage of the Affordable Care Act in 2012, we knew in San Francisco that we were going to have to enroll close to 100,000 people, which would significantly increase our caseload, almost doubling it. This group of four couldn't have done this in a more effective way.
We're trying to put more food on the table for low-income working San Franciscans.
Thanks, everyone. Hi, I'm Trent Rohr. I'm the Executive Director of the Human Services Agency, which is the agency that was tasked with enrolling all of the newly eligibles under the Affordable Care Act. When the Affordable Care Act passed, and we ran some of the numbers, I thought to myself and ultimately said to my leadership team, this is the most monumental shift in health and social policy that we will be implementing in San Francisco in terms of its effect on numbers of people. We enrolled over 95,000 San Franciscans in expanded Medicaid through the Affordable Care Act. And I just wish... the right people aren't here right now to hear those numbers, unfortunately. But they know. Not only did we do that, but this team, in their vision, understood that not only access to healthcare, but access to affordable, nutritious food could be done at the same time. And that's what the SF Benefits team is all about, healthcare and nutrition, two fundamental human rights, and expanding it to over 95,000 people. And let me tell you, we didn't expand our staff in equal increments to match that 95,000. It was them who figured out how to do it and how to do it efficiently and how to provide great service to our San Franciscans. I couldn't be more proud of them. I think when faced with that task, what guided them and what they were able to communicate to their staffs is the vision and the belief in the vision that everyone is entitled to health care in this country, in this state, in this city, and that guided them through the roughest of days and roughest of weeks and months and years. So guys, congratulations, so well deserved. We bring them forward now. Mary Adrian, Noel Pinello, Tania Ferreira, and Leo O'Farrell.
Thank you, Trent. Thank you, Mayor Lee. Wow, there's a lot of people to thank. But you know, it starts from our staff. We have an incredible group of staff who, I won't go into all the logistics and the workarounds and everything else, but they stayed passionate. They stayed committed. They had their vision on our goal of getting as many people health care as we could. And then we combined it with food stamps, CalFresh. They stayed committed. I want to put out a shout out to the management teams too. Without your passion, without your entire hard work, your innovation, your coming to me screaming and saying, but I have an idea, we couldn't have gotten through this. You also have a great sense of humor, and well, it's actually a wicked sense of humor, and you make me want to come to work. So we don't know what the future holds. We don't know what the administration is going to do towards healthcare or towards CalFresh. But here's what I do know. We promise the citizens of San Francisco that we will look you in the eye, we will treat you like the individuals you are, we will listen to your needs and your concerns, and we will do our darndest to get you the help you need. When we have as many people as we do receiving health care coverage and CalFresh, it's not just them who benefit from this. All of us benefit from this. So lastly, I want to say, it's not just a great job to have. It's an honor to do this every single day. It's an honor and a privilege. And it takes a team. It takes a team who work well together, who can argue together, who can come through it together, and together we're stronger, and good night. Okay.
All
right, thank you, and congratulations. And I'd like to thank Mayor Lee and all of our other honored guests for joining us tonight for our 37th annual Good Government Awards. We hope that you all would join us for a drink in the back, and that concludes our program. Thank you all.